Hello, hello, this is Serenef, and we are playing Creative Earths Gone Wired. This video is part of a series of step-by-step tutorials that assume no previous experience with circuitry, virtual or otherwise. In this video, we'll be constructing an edge detector circuit, which can be used with larger machines and clocking devices. But first, we'll create an inverter out of a logic gate, we'll learn the difference between the two, and we'll revisit distance as it pertains to Creative Earths machines. If you're very new to Creativeverse machines, I recommend starting with the first video in the series, Let There Be Light. In the description, I've also linked Truth Table's chart, which has all the different logic gates and what results we get with each combination of inputs. We'll be using this chart a couple of times throughout the video. For most simple circuits, inputs and outputs are straightforward. Turn the switch on and the LED turns on. Turn the switch off, the LED turns off. As time passes, the signal changes from false to true, and then back to false again, or if we're speaking binary, from 0 to 1, and back to 0 again. But what if we don't want a constant signal? What if we want just a small pulse to tell us when the signal changes? If we're looking for changes in the signal, we're looking for these spots. The change from 0 to 1 is called the rising edge, and from 1 to 0, the falling edge. How can we make a circuit to detect the rising edge? We want to see a pulse right as the switch is turned on. That means we want a signal to make to the LED, but we also want it to cancel immediately afterward. Thankfully, there's already a theoretical schematic we can follow in the real world. Here we have an AND gate with inverters in front of one of the AND's inputs. Let's add a little something to this image to make it clearer what we're looking at. There. In this circuit, the AND gate is already primed with one true input from the odd number of inverters. When the signal travels to both the AND's second input and the inverters slow down the signal with their own propagation delay, leaving a very brief moment when both inputs of the AND gate are true. When the inverters have processed the signal, they change the signal to false, meaning the AND gate no longer has two true signals. The result is a very tiny true impulse from the AND gate. Let's try that with Creativeverse machines. Remember, you can hold down shift to keep the wire in your hand. Alright. This doesn't seem to be working. The circuit seems simple enough, so what gives? There are actually two ways Creativeverse machines work differently than real-world circuits that might explain why a direct transposition will not work. I've talked before about propagation delay, and here I've reconstructed part of my experiments from the previous video. The switch connects to an OR gate, a delay gate set to 0 seconds, and an inverter. Each of those is connected to another of its kind, and the second to a third, and the third to a fourth, and so on. When we turn on the switch, we should see the changes move from the first machines to the last in this line, as each machine must process the signal before moving it on. So let's try that. Did we see that correctly? Let's try again. The lines of delay and logic gates exhibit propagation delay, but it seems the inverters show no delay at all. Unlike other gates, inverters seem to process their logic instantaneously, which means we cannot rely on them for propagation delay in our edge detector. So what can we do? We know that logic gates have propagation delay. Let's use one of those. Pop quiz. Inverters take a signal and turn it to its opposite. When the switch is on and outputting true, the inverter outputs false. When the switch is off and outputting false, the inverter outputs true. Using just one logic gate, set to NAND, how can we connect the switch to the LED so that the LED shows an inverted output? Pause the video if you'd like. NAND will output true for everything except two true inputs, but we can make sure the inputs are always the same by connecting the switch to both of them at once. When the switch is turned on, it sends a true signal to both of the NAND's inputs, making the gate output false. When we turn the switch off, it outputs false to both of the NAND's inputs, meaning the output will be true. We've created an inverter out of a NAND gate. Bonus question. What other gate can we use in this exact same way to act as an inverter? That is, which other gate will give us a false output when both inputs are true and a true output when both inputs are false? The answer? NOR. If we compare our inverter to our new NAND inverter, we can see the output of the NAND is just a bit slower than the standard inverter. We now have an inverter with propagation delay. Let's set up our edge detector with our new NAND inverter, just like the real-world schematic. Not working. Maybe we need three? Oof. It's working. That's good, but... Wow, that pulse is actually quite long. That almost feels like a whole second. Not really the quick pulse that we're expecting for our machines. There's actually one more thing going on here that you might not be aware of. A lesser-known way that Creativerse machines are different from real-world circuits. The latter are analog, running on real-world physics, where two occurrences can happen at the exact same time, like a pig's eat walking in your way. But here in Creativerse, where we play in a virtual environment produced by lines of code processed by our own computers one command at a time, two occurrences cannot happen at the exact same time. one gate will always process before the other. I think we forced a lot of that processing to happen with a huge number of NAND forwarders here, but I think we can reduce that back to one with one additional change. Let's say the game processes the sequence of events something like this. At a resting state, with the switch off, the NAND inverter outputs true, and the AND, with one true and one false input, outputs false. The LED is off. We flip the switch, so it outputs true. Only one of the machines can process its inputs at one time. Let's assume it's the NAND inverter. The NAND updates its output based on the change to its input. It's now outputting false. It's NAND's turn to process its inputs, which are currently one true and one false, with one true and one false input, and cannot output true, which means our LED was never able to light up. How then can we take the AND gate and make sure it processes before the NAND inverter? As it turns out, distance really does matter. Let's reconnect. When one signal goes to multiple inputs, the closest input usually gets processed first. So if we want to make sure the AND gate is processed first, we need to make sure it's closer to our switch than the NAND inverter. If the AND gate processes the signal first, we'll have a moment when the AND has a true output before the NAND inverter changes the AND gate a second time. Let's try it, this time placing our NAND inverter further from the input than our AND. Perfect! Exactly what we want to see. A very short burst. But wait, you say, what if the distance from the source input is the reason the original inverter didn't work? That's very scientific of you. Let's try it. Again, we see the inverter gate completely lacks the necessary propagation delay. We will have to stick to our NANDverter. What if we want a different kind of edge detector? What if we want an otherwise steady signal to give us a negative pulse only on the falling edge? Let's work with our current setup of NAND inverter and logic gate and plan our desired result. When the switch is off and the system is at a resting state, one input will be false and the other input, because of the NAND inverter, will be true. Here, we want a true input. When the switch first turns on, one input will be true. We'll have a moment when the NAND inverter is still true. This is the rising edge, not the falling one, so we want to continue seeing a true input. Next, the NAND inverter will process the change in its input and changes its output. The inputs for the logic gate are again one true and one false. We're not at the falling edge yet, so we still want to see that true signal. Time to turn the switch off, which means its output changes from true to false, from 1 to 0. We'll have a moment when the NAND inverter will still be false before it processes the change in its signal. This is our falling edge when we want to see an inverted pulse. Output false. Finally, the NAND inverter processes the signal and outputs true. This pulse should end, so we want to return to a true output from our logic gate. Looking over the list of our desired behaviors from our logic gate and referencing our chart, can we see which setting would give us the results we want? The only time the logic gate should output false is when both inputs are false. Of all our gates, only the OR gate follows this rule. Let's try it. OR. Perfect! Just by changing the kind of gate, we've made a different kind of edge detector. In fact, each setting on the logic gate produces a different kind of edge detection circuit. With just two logic gates, we can create six different types of edge detectors. A rising edge detector, using the AND gate. An inverted rising edge detector, using a NAND gate. A falling edge detector, using a NOR gate. An inverted falling edge detector, using the OR gate. An indiscriminate edge detector, that means it detects both falling and rising edges, using the XNOR gate. And finally, the inverted indiscriminate edge detector, which stays on except for any edge, using an XOR gate. Future videos are in the works. If you'd like to be notified when the next upload goes up, hit the bell button next to subscribe, and be sure to check out the other Gone Wired videos in this series, and links in the description to other great Creativerse content creators working with machines. Until next time, take care.